The Unsung War Casualties. This is a foreword from my sister Marianne, who obtained these letters from Forrest Saxon. And I'm going to read this to you, so listen carefully. Having recently rekindled my interest in my family history due to my work on genealogy, I realized that I might never know a part of my dad's life that was certainly a major influence on him, the time he spent as a prisoner during World War II. Because Dad never talks about this time, I decided to write to Forrest Saxon. I knew he and Dad were friends during this time, and how happy Dad was when Mr. Saxon re-entered his life after so many years. But it wasn't until I wrote to Mr. Saxon that I learned the importance and the impact each had on the other's life. Though it was difficult, both physically and emotionally, Mr. Saxon generously devoted much time and effort to retell many accounts of their time while being held prisoners of the Germans. I have experienced mixed emotions as I have read these letters, known here as chapters. There is happiness in having had a chance to learn these events. There is great sadness knowing that they had to endure what they had to endure. There is pride in knowing these two men, and there is a deep respect for all those who have served our country. I have compiled Mr. Saxon's letters so that we, Bernie's children, and Mr. Saxon's children, will have a better understanding of all that they have gone through. I hope that what I am sharing will not be too upsetting, but rather will give insight to the lives of these two great men. Thank you, Mr. Saxon, for sharing this with us. I scrolled to the top. I want to show you a couple more pictures. What is this World War II thing? How did it start? Why did it start? Well, I'm going to click on a couple of things. Here's a map. Most of what is taking place is right in this area of Europe, Germany. This is where my dad was, specifically in this area. The United States is all the way over here. Another part of the war was happening in the South Pacific over by Japan. So maybe over here on the right-hand side, some other parts of the World War were taking place. But again, my dad, where he was concentrated right here in Europe, in the center of the screen. Who was involved? Mainly Great Britain, France, the Soviet Union, and the United States would be considered the Allies, the Axis powers, the bad guys, Germany, Italy, and Japan. And we consider them friends today. But back then, with Adolf Hitler as a Nazi dictator, Benito Mussolini as a fascist dictator, and Tojo for Japan was an emperor, the prime minister. These people were really doing some evil things in their parts of the country and the way they ruled. And there were other sub-countries, smaller countries that were on each side, but those were the main ones. Next. Who's this guy, Adolf Hitler? Well, again, a very evil person in Germany. And we can see a picture of him there. People were scared to death, literally, of him. People were executed all the time. And this guy was behind it. How could a guy like Hitler come into power? Well, economically speaking, it was in between wars, World War I and World War II. Hitler was part of World War I, but when he became the leader of Germany, he started to help some economic growth in Germany. And some people kind of liked that. Obviously, they were starting to eat better, and they had nicer buildings, nicer facilities, nicer roads, nicer cars, and he was a big part of that. He ruled with an iron fist, so people kind of liked it, but they were also very scared of him. A lot of people, though, did not like the way that this was taking place within Germany, so there was some dissension amongst some of the people and the citizens in Germany. I'm not an historian, but I can't tell you everything about that, but those are some of the things that I do know. Another picture of Hitler is shown here. This is him. You can see how the people just showed up. Thousands of people would show up and almost worship this guy, maybe out of fear. But you can see the crowds that he drew. Here's another picture. Probably the same place. You can see like stadiums all filled with soldiers and people all in line. It was scary stuff. It was scary stuff. Here's some of Hitler's youth. I'm not really going to get into that, but again, some young people also were sort of brought up into this culture and almost brainwashed, if you will, to follow Hitler's ways. I'm going to click on another one here. Hopefully it shows up. I'm not sure, but I believe this is a picture of some Jewish children. The Jews were persecuted greatly by Hitler, and the ones that survived were put in camps, maybe used as slaves. Again, very harsh conditions, very little food, and eventually most of the Jews, I believe up to 6 million estimated, were killed, exterminated by Adolf Hitler simply because of who they were. This deals with the Holocaust. In this picture, you can see just how thin some of these people were. My dad also, not part of the Holocaust, but as a German prisoner of the Germans, lost a lot of weight, was down around 100 pounds when he was liberated because of the lack of food that he had. We'll learn all about that. This is a crematorium. It's believed that many Jews were exterminated, assassinated in these crematoriums. This is a situation where maybe they are already dead and just cremated, but a lot of people claim that many Jews were also burned alive in these ovens. We're not going to talk about Anne Frank, but many of you may have read The Diary of a Young Girl dealing with Anne Frank and heard of her story. Again, all related to this time period during World War II. She is believed to have been caught by the Germans and probably executed, because we never heard anything from her after that. Some pictures of Pearl Harbor. There are lots of theories of how we got into the war. Pearl Harbor may have been the last straw, where allies of the Germans, the Japanese, bombed Pearl Harbor. Headlines, 1,500 dead in Hawaii, Congress votes war. I believe Hitler also declared war on the United States, a fact that I'm not 1,000% sure of, but those are things that I've heard. And one more picture. The war ended. We're really not going to talk about this, with the bombings of Nagasaki and Hiroshima, this atomic bomb going off in Japan, and basically Japan, which was another part of the war, surrendered, and the war was officially over. Okay, I'm going to now fade out of this and get started with Chapter 1 of The Unsung War Casualties.